Hello, everyone. My name is Tamman Sursok. This is Fern McCain, and we're shooting In Bed with Tamman in an English accent the whole time.
I actually thought there was a British person.
Let me explain to everyone who the incredible Fern McCain is. McCann.
You can say McCain, but it is actually McCann. But I'll let you off.
McCann. Where is your claim to fame?
So I started on Towie, which is basically where I'm from. It's a county in the UK. It's like, do you remember the hills?
Yes.
Following a young group of people.
So you are Kristen Cavallari in the UK.
Pretty much.
Pretty much.
I see myself more as the Lauren Conrad, but more wild.
I completely see that too. But then you did I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here. Then you have an autobiography, Cross My Heart. Plus, you ate a live spider on national television. I watched that last night, and I physically found it really hard to watch the rest of the episode. Did it pop in your mouth?
It was just insane.
What did it taste like?
I'm not gonna lie. It was horrific. I can't even describe the taste. It was crunchy. It was foul. The taste was like a cockroach.
No!
Not many people have eaten
Who would eat a cockroach?
I've eaten one of
those. You are my absolute hero. So do you have any regrets in your life? What is your biggest regret?
This is mad crazy that you asked me this question.
Okay.
Because
like
this morning, this is
or
insane.
The gin.
We are, do you like the gin?
I do like the gin. I'm taking it very slow, but this is pretty sexy and
it's
tasty.
Refreshing,
it's
isn't it?
It's very refreshing.
Cheers. I'm glad you like it. Okay, so this morning I woke up and I'm in LA for the first time.
I've
popped my LA cherry and I thought, I want to...
popping cherries left, right and center.
I want to move out here. It's daunting. It's
very
scary.
I came out here with two suitcases. I was 20 years old. I didn't know anyone. I'd come from a show, Home and Away. I came here. I thought I was going to be a big star. Completely fell flat on my face and had to start again. It's really, really scary, but it takes a lot of guts and it takes a lot of balls, and I promise you that you won't regret it.
It's now or never, I feel.
It's now or never. And I will be here for you. We can set up an apartment. We can
find
a guy to date. I mean, are you dating anyone? Tell me about Russell Brand.
I knew you was going to ask
I'm
me
sorry.
About him.
You wrote it in your autobiography.
I did.
How can I not ask about this?
Yeah, he was someone that I met when I was 18.
Wow.
And then before I was famous.
Yeah.
That's why it was such a cool story. That's why I had to put it in the book.
Guys, you're going to have to read the book if you want to know.
What do you want to know about it, though?
Did you kiss him?
Yeah.
Did you see you naked?
Yeah, he saw me naked.
That's so cool. I don't even have, I think Leonardo DiCaprio once said like, hey girl. That was about
Stop.
It. That's about all I've got. I've had no casting couch, which I'm really offended by. No famous people. No one wants to have sex with me but my husband. Sorry, husband. But like, I've had no like famous person who's been like, take your clothes off.
Don't beat yourself down like that.
I know,
Leonardo saying hey is...
Hey, girl.
It's a pretty big deal.
This is one question I really want to talk to you about because it's affected me in my life. I used to be quite overweight when I was a kid. I had a lot of eating problems when I was growing up. I was body shamed my whole life. We now hide behind our keyboards and we tell people that they look disgusting or don't look perfect, and it affects people, and how dare people do that. It's happened to me. I think it's happened to you too.
God, yeah.
How do you want the world to change or social media to change? So this is not okay.
Yesterday, I found out that in the States, I'm a plus size. Like, first of all, how can we even be labeled? We should be labeled plus size, size zero, all this bullshit. But like, I was just like, I couldn't believe it, because a plus size, not that there's anything wrong with being a plus size.
You're a beautiful, beautiful figure. You should not wake up any morning and feel bad about yourself. And you know, most men, which I beg anyone to say that this is wrong, would rather have sex with somebody who's curvy than somebody who's not eating. I promise you, it's not attractive and it's not sexy.
You need people that are like in the public eye, or you know, bloggers or whatever with a big following, that just can step out and be like, okay, not to conform, not to be size zero, and say, I am a realistic
beautiful
size
woman.
10, curvy, pushing size 12 on a good day. And that's how it is. I like to eat. Last night, yes, I went to In-N-Out Burger and I went animal style. And I'm not afraid to do it. I think healthy, you've got to be healthy.
Yeah, absolutely. And you have to love yourself.
See you there.
I
never burp. This is a really weird thing. I think
I don't burp.
You're either a burper or
you're either
farter.
A burper or you're farter.
What are you?
A farter.
A farter. I am a farter.
Do you fart?
Because I do.
Do my husband fart. I can't say fart. Farts. He just lets it come out, and then we just sit there, and it's like the big egg in the room that he's farted, and I'm like, we all smell it, and he's like, I don't know what you're like. I don't
trap
know
that
what you're talking
under the duvet.
Yeah, but then the problem with me is like I'm such a horrible wife. Like I want it to like free out and just so he's frustrated. Do you know I've never seen my husband go to the bathroom?
Stop.
10 years.
That's not normal.
Isn't that? I think that's weird. Is
that's
that weird?
That's weird.
I can carry on a conversation on the toilet, drink coffee, like have my daughter in my lap, eat chocolate, like all of it I can do on the toilet. Learn a monologue. I've never seen, I don't even know if he goes to the bathroom. I don't know.
I think that it can take your relationship from here to here. If you're having a shower and your man's sitting on the toilet.
That's real intimacy, guys.
It's just something that has to be ticked off the list.
You have to move here. It's really, really important. You have to make your dreams come true. I will be your first friend, and I will even poop in front of you.
Whoa. I mean, I have that in writing?
Yeah.
Because that is a statement.
Yeah, I know.
It means a lot, Tam.
Oh, my God.
Thanks, boo.
Thank you for being here.
No,
we
thanks
love
for
you
having
dearly.
Me.
And thank you guys for watching In Bed with Tammin. Please subscribe to my channel, leave comments below on who you want to see in bed with Tammin, and follow Fern McCann at Fern McCann. Bye.
Bye, guys. Mwah.
Would you rather eat pudding that tastes like shit or eat shit that tastes like pudding?
This is the worst, stupidest question.
What? Well, you're not gonna eat shit that tastes like pudding, are you?
But you have, but,
yes,
but then it's gonna taste.
Can I order the side of shit that tastes like pudding? No, I'm gonna order pudding that tastes like shit, and I'm gonna send that shit back.